All right, guys, today I went up to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, and got me another transmission out of a launcher of 2005. Pretty good looking shape, to be honest with you. What I liked about it was it wasn't all cleaned up. Like, you get something from LQ or LKQ or whatever, they have it all cleaned up, and you can see all the shit that's wrong with it. But this is, you know, 115,000 miles is what's on this one, but looks really clean. Had very little bit of metal on the bottom of it, and they didn't even drain they only drained so much of the fluid. So that was pretty cool to see that there's only a little bit of in the magnet, and you could tell the fluid's like original, so no one's been changing that. So that's all the metal that's been on it since, you know, since it was new, 115,000. I guarantee you, it didn't look like anything's been touched. Sucks they took that one out. They must have took that out at first, but it has the new plastic, like these bushings right there. You can tell that they've never been taken out, or that they would crack. When they retorque them back in, they must always crack. But it's real, you know, go. That's the dirt that's on it, but you could clean that up easily. It's definitely not all oil pitted and everything like that. So I don't know if they have the engine to this car or not. I might have to look. Wouldn't mind getting another engine for a decent price for to rebuild. Yeah, I mean, no more dumb holes where they drilled in because the LQ idiots were too dumb to know what they were doing. This was black until I blew it off. The rust was, you know, there, but it lets you know that it wasn't leaking oil, transaxle seals and everything like that. You know, not leaking oil at all. It's got those metal transaxle seals in it from factory. So, they're not leaking. But probably should change them. They're better than the rubber ones, but that's all they ever sell anymore is the rubber ones. I don't even think the OEM ones that you can get anymore have the metal in them. I mean, you can even tell just that this has never been out. These pins, they kind of like fold, so they're like the second time you put them in. Third time you put them in, they pop out so easily. I'm sweating like hell, guys. It's 105 degrees here. It sucks. You know, even this right here is clean, and this up here is clean. And yeah, I'm really happy with it. Everything goes through good, so we just got to tear it apart and put the LSD in it. First, I got to get the other transmission out, but really happy with this. If I took it and got it cleaned up, it would be really nice. My other transit's in it. I cleaned it twice and it's still not this clean. But everyone knows me, I'm not much into making them look good. Anytime I make something look good, usually don't last. So the other one lasted, I thought it was a year and 5 months, but it was a year and 2 months and a lot of pulls, guys. Thousands of, probably 1,000 pulls at the track, on the street. Everything. So I can't really complain about that last transmission. I mean, man, I probably put 15,000 miles on it the last year. Hard miles. I ran the 11.1 in it, which was the world's fastest beta for a while. It still is the world's fastest stock beta Tiburon, but not the world's fastest beta anymore stock. But maybe we can get this transmission here to hit 10 seconds. That's the goal next, right, guys? Hit that 10. Got something else I want to show you guys. I think you'll like this shit. Got everything at Real Street this time. All right, guys, if you want to start ordering your ARP head studs, Real Street might be the place to go. I paid a little bit cheaper than I normally would for main studs. And I got them pretty quick. There's your part number for the main studs. And you need 10 of them. It's your ARP mains right there. This is important, guys, if you want to make power. And then you need 10 washers. Part number right there. It's the cheapest way to buy those. I think I did show you guys long enough. And then, obviously, you need 10 of these. Real Street hooked me up with some shirts. And then, the most important thing we got here, though, is powder rods. These are going to be something special to have in the car. They got ARP 2000s. They got all the torque specs and everything in the... There we go. It won't come up. Damn thing does not like the... Anyway, there are ARP 2000s in there. Nice thick rod as well. I'm not taking it out of the plastic. There's no use in it. Everything looks really good. Obviously, to make some good power. These are X-Beams rods. Shouldn't have no problem with 800 horse, 800 horsepower, 700 wheel horsepower with these rods. Definitely. Let's see. There we go. That's your number on these right here. I think that's everything on them. But yeah, that's your basically your part number right there, guys, for your powder rods. It's the part number for the 2.0 liter. 2.0 liter, beta 1, beta 2 take the same rods. So it doesn't matter. But I'm really happy with those. We got some custom cut pistons coming yet. And once I get those, I'll show you them. Then we got some strong wrist pins coming as well. The goal is going to be 800 horsepower one day. But we'll step it up. We'll probably put it straight to 600 maybe. And then probably straight to 6. But we'll tone it down to where we can drive it around like 400 horse, because obviously we blew the transmission already on 400 horse and it lasted a while. So you could probably turn it up to 556, but probably as soon as you go to dig race, you're probably going to start blowing shit apart. But I guess we have enough transmissions around here with the beta 1 cars. I really don't like the beta 1 trans to keep it on the road. But the best thing to do, we'll start out low and we'll work our way up. I'd like to just run it on the street, 400, that's plenty. Option to turn it up to 600. Just mostly run 6 on the track and try to cut some times. Obviously want to get a built tranny next. I'll talk to you guys about that. I was going to get the built tranny instead of the powder rods and the pistons I got coming. And you know, all this stuff here. I drive this thing everywhere, daily it, and drive it like 100 miles one way a lot of times just to go racing. I try to drive it everywhere. It's a street car, so it'd be nice to have a reliable motor, and then we need a reliable trans. But right now, we know that the transmissions can be pretty reliable, especially if you're not out beating on it all the time. But I beat the hell out of that transmission, and look how long it lasted, guys. So, a little over a year it lasted. So, you can't beat that. We got a new trans, as we've seen in the front, beginning of this video. And that's going to get linked up, hopefully, this week to the car. And we'll have it back out running by next weekend. Hopefully at the track by next weekend after. see what we can do. The heat's here right now, so we're not going to really go for any times, guys. We got to wait till like September, October, and we'll try to nail out some times. And I'm not sure when I'll have this, everything with this and everything I need to build it, so I'm not quite sure when we'll get to get it built. Might be a winter thing, or we might have it time for October to maybe crack out a low 10 second pass. World record's 10-2. Be nice to run a 10-1 and miss right out the gate, right? Made it back home, and we got a 38,000 mile transmission, pretty damn clean. It's nighttime now. I took my time getting back, and now I'm about to go to bed. Thanks for watching.